Hi all, today we'll try to understand the topic called photogrammetry. Under photogrammetry, today we'll discuss about geometry of elements of vertical aerial photographs, determination of ground length and angle, and relief displacement. So, geometric elements of vertical photographs can be identified based on ground datum, then on negative data which is storing at the focal plane, and positive data so as per the focal length. The determination of ground length and angle can also be identified based on ground coordinate system. Ground coordinate system can be calculated based on again photo coordinate system. Then relief displacement is also possible to identify, so based on height of the object which is able to see in the aerial photograph. First we will try to understand what is geometric elements of a vertical photograph. So if you see in this lecture, here we can identify the diagram which is showing various details like ground datum, where we can identify ground datum is considered as capital ABCD. So same ground datum we are able to identify, so by means of negative data as A dash, B dash, C dash and D dash. Here we can see that data is storing diagonally in opposite direction. So negative data where we can identify is stored at focal plane with the length of focal length. Then when we create the positive data, then the same negative data can be replaced as positive, which is matching with respect to ground coordinates like small a, b, c, d. Here also again data to be considered with the equal to the focal length, so that we can maintain the uniform scale. Then we can see that say for example ground datum point capital A is stored as A dash diagonally, then same can be placed at small a it positive data. So then if you see the likewise, all the ground datum points are exactly following in the negative data as for diagonal, then same can be seen where data is storing at negative. Then same can be make into positive, so that we can see that points are exactly matching. So capital A is stored as small a, capital B as small b, capital C as small c, and capital D as small d, so which are at with the same scale. So it can be seen that whatever the focal length we are considering, even in positive data also we need to understand. Here in photograph is illustrated with the same positive with the focal length amount. Then say for example E is, assume that E is another point which is stored at photograph where in negative data E dash, where we can see that if you see the coordinate system here, E is stored as a small E dash at opposite corner, but same can be identified and positive, which is exactly matching with the ground coordinate system. Then optical axis can be seen. O dash is the, I mean, if you see the principal point on the ground datum, where optical axis is exactly falling at the principal point, same point can be seen on the negative data as O dash, and the small o at positive data. So then here we need to understand it is uniform terrain, but sometimes we may be seeing that a relief displacement on a photograph taken over varied terrain. So terrain is not uniform, then we need to understand various point locations are falling at different places even in photograph. So here we can understand whatever the irrespective of terrain, we need to bring the into average datum. So here we can identify the highlighted area is nothing but average datum elevation with respect to mean sea level. But here if you see here, point A or object A which is above the average datum. But if you see the resultant image on photograph scale, particular image point with respect to datum is coming inside the photograph. So we need to remember here, if object height is above the average datum, so particular point, datum point is falling inside the photograph than with respect to original point. If you see the point B here, so here we can see that the elevation of point B is below the average datum. So if you see the same reflectance on aerial photograph, it is outward. We can understand it is falling at outward. Then C can be seen that another C point, it is exactly at the average datum level, so there is no displacement in the case of point C because it is exactly with respect to average datum. Then even horizontal angles can also be seen here. If you see here angle between ACB, we can understand here we can see that observed angle, is it not? Then but actually what we are recording with respect to datum are nothing but A dash C and B dash. It is what a true angle we need to understand. So angle is also going to change with respect to datum. So that is about geometric elements. It is very important to go for the further calculations. Then second topic here, determination of horizontal ground length and angles from photo coordinates. Here we need to understand whatever the ground length and angle, for that we need to have the coordinate system or coordinates. So based on photo coordinates, we can easily calculate the ground coordinates. When we are able to identify the ground coordinates, we can find out the horizontal length between point A and B on the ground. So here we can understand capital A and B are the point locations on the ground with their elevations H capital A and H capital B respectively. It means that point A is at above the datum with HA, and point B is also having its own height called HB. So we can understand ground coordinate system capital X and Y. Then same which is also it is representing as photo coordinates by means of small X and Y. So because we need to understand here coordinate system, especially X coordinate system, to be considered because it is nothing but flight line direction, flight line coordinate system. Whatever the flight direction we are seeing, which we are matching with respect to X coordinate system. That's why all the objects locations can be calculated with respect to coordinate system. Then see here, ground coordinate system and photo coordinate systems are considered. So we can also see that point A and B are having their own locations, but point that respect to A and B, locations can be considered with respect to ground coordinate system. It means that point location has to be placed on XY coordinate system. So here we can understand capital A dash and B dash are locations on ground coordinate system. So whatever the location it may be, has to move on to the X coordinate system or simultaneously onto the Y coordinate system. So we can also understand small A dash and B dash are nothing but locations on photo coordinate system. Even in photograph we can also understand simply same point A and B are replaced onto the X coordinate system, where we can identify A dash and B dash respectively. So we can identify point A exactly at photo coordinates or on the photograph. Then we can understand whatever the A dash, capital A dash, which is nothing but a location of A with respect to ground coordinate system. Same thing has to be identified on photo coordinate system. So A can be identified. It means that A dash is nothing but distance from origin O to the point A on x-axis. that is called the distance we are considering as XA. So A dash can be represented as a small A dash on a photo. So respectively we can understand B dash also. Here then we can understand, we can derive the particular coordinates. So from the similar triangles, you try to concentrate here, from similar triangles L, capital L, OA and A dash, and capital L, small O and small A dash. From the similar triangles L, OA, A dash and L, small O, small A dash, small XA by capital XA equal to, so small XA is nothing but photo distance, I mean distance from origin to the point A dash on X coordinate system on photo scale. Then capital XA is nothing but same distance from origin to the point on X coordinate system, I mean X ground coordinate system. So XA by XA is equal to F divided by H minus HA. So F is nothing but focal length. We can understand the distance between exposure station to the origin O. Same can be represented on ground coordinate system by means of total height minus height of the object. We can understand L to capital O is nothing but capital H, nothing but height of the flight with respect to mean sea level. Then we also need to understand A point is having its own elevation above the mean sea level. So F divided by H minus HA dash. Then here we can understand again from the similar triangles capital L A dash A and capital L small A dash A. So L A dash A to L A dash A, I mean between ground coordinates to photo coordinate. Again YA can be calculated. So small YA is nothing but location of small A with respect to Y coordinate system on photograph to the capital YA is nothing but, again we can need to understand, so ground distance on Y coordinate system. Okay, so YA by YA is equal to same as like previous triangle F divided by H minus HA, that is nothing but height difference, right? So if you see here XA by XA and YA by YA are both are same, F divided by H minus small HA. So then if the capital AB be two ground point having elevations HA and HB above the mean sea level and the coordinates, so we need to understand ground coordinates are capital XA YA and XB YB. So same coordinate system can be identified on photo, so where point AB are the positions of corresponding ground points, the photographic coordinates are small XA, YA, small XB, YB. So from the previous equation, XA by XB equal to YA by YB equal to F divided by H minus H dash. So same equation here we can understand. So from XA by XA is equal to F by H minus H dash. So from the equation, so we can get the coordinate value for capital XA. Capital XA is nothing but X coordinate system of point A on the ground. So capital XA can be written small XA into H minus HA by F. So the equation can be written XA is equal to, so H minus HA by F can be written as 1 by scale. So because the scale equation, we know that scale is equal to F divided by H minus H dash. So that can be considered as 1 by scale into a small XA, right? So likewise, we can calculate another point coordinates like YA, YB, like XA, XB. So we can see here where XA is equal to H minus HA by F into XA, XB is equal to H minus HB. Here point B is coming, then we need to understand the elevation of the particular point to be noticed here. H minus HB by F into XB, then YA and YB. So here what we need to understand, simply to say that ground coordinate can be considered by multiplying the reciprocal of the scale with respect to photo coordinate. Simply, ground coordinate is equal to ground coordinate of a point equal to photo coordinate of that point into 1 by scale. So ground coordinate system can be achieved by multiplying the reciprocal of the scale with the photo coordinate. If the capital XA is the ground coordinate, capital XA is equal to 1 by scale into, reciprocal of the scale into photo coordinate of that point. Okay, if you know the photo coordinates and the scale, we can find out the ground coordinates. Likewise, we need to identify x comma y for the case of point. If there are n number of points, then xa, ya, xb, yb, xn and yn coordinates will be there. Once we are able to identify xa, xb, then ya, yb. So it means that point A is having its own coordinate called capital XA and YA. So from the ground coordinate system, as per the Pythagorean theorem, horizontal ground length between point AB can be calculated by using the equation AB is equal to square root XA minus XB whole square plus YA minus YB whole square. So once we are able to identify the equation, then angle can also be measured between AB from the B by equation alpha is equal to tan inverse XA minus XB by YA minus YB. So by using these two equation, length and angle can be measured with respect to ground coordinate system. Ground coordinates can be calculated from the photo coordinates with their reciprocal of the scale. Then third point we need to understand, relief displacement. So relief displacement can be identified with respect to photo coordinate system. Here we can understand the geometric components of relief displacement by means of identifying a tower with its own point A is the top of the tower, and capital A dash is nothing but base of the particular tower. If you see the height, tower height is small h, then the same can be seen on photo scale on a aerial photograph. Small a is the top of the tower, then a small a dash is nothing but the base point on the photograph. The distance can also be identified here. We can see that the line is joining capital A. We know that the elevation top point of the tower, then which is recorded in the aerial photograph by means of small a. But we can also see that a double dash is nothing but tower height called capital A point on the ground location. Whatever the point we are able to see with respect to exposure station, that point angle point is falling on the ground. That is nothing but A double dash. Okay. Then we can understand the point capital A, tower top is recorded in the photograph as A dash. Same point is located as a double dash on the ground. So point capital A is located as small a in the photograph, then capital A double dash on the ground. Then capital A dash is nothing but base point of the tower, can be recorded as a small a dash on the photograph. Then we can see that location of base point on the ground as well as on the aerial photograph. Then can also see that, distance from origin to the point A in the photograph in the form of radial distance, small r, then same as recorded in the ground as capital R. Small r and capital R nothing but radial distance of the outer point on the map as well as on the ground. Small r represent distance from origin to the A on the photograph. Capital R is nothing but same distance from the origin capital O to the A double dash on the ground. So we can also see that D is nothing but a displacement. It means that capital D is nothing but a distance from A dash to A double dash. We can understand when sunlight is exposed on A, then the shadow point we are able to understand. Here also we need to understand distance from base point to the A point on the ground called A double dash. Same can be seen on photo by means of small d, distance between A dash to A. Then height can also be differentiated by means of small h is tower height, then capital H is nothing but flying height with respect to ground level. So we can express small d as a function of the dimension, is nothing but a displacement here. So from the similar triangles called capital A dash and A double dash and L O A double dash, we need to understand here both the triangles are similar triangles only. From these similar triangles, capital D by H can be written as capital R by H. So D by H is equal to, distance by height is equal to R by H. Okay. So as we are considering the distances capital D and R at the scale of photograph, we need to understand to find out the any calculation, need to identify the scale of the photograph. So capital D and capital R can be considered with respect to photo scale. It means that small d and small r. So from the equation it can be rearranged by means of small d by small h is equal to small r by capital H. So when you rearrange the equation, d is equal to, when you send the h into other side, then d is equal to r h by h. It is the fundamental equation for the displacement called photo displacement or relief displacement. D is equal to RH by capital H, where small d is relief displacement, small r is equal to radial distance on the photograph from the principal point to the displaced image point, that is from origin. Small h is nothing but height above the datum of the object point, means that the height of the object above the datum. Capital H is nothing but flying height above the same datum chosen to reference H. So whatever the datum we consider with respect to same datum, height of the flight, right? So relief displacement can be calculated when you know the RH and H. To calculate the displacement, you should know the radial distance. That can be easily calculated on the photograph. We also need to understand a small h and a capital H also to be required. So from this equation, we can also find out height. See here, same we can see that d is equal to rh by h can be rearranged by means of h is equal to, right? So from that equation, object height h is equal to d capital H by small r. When you arrange the same equation, h is equal to, you send the h to that side and r by divided by. So h is equal to dh by r. I hope you understood here. H is nothing but height. So it means that when we know the displacement, we can find out the height, or vice versa. When you know the height, displacement can also be calculated. Here there is a small example. From the figure, we can assume that relief displacement of tower A is 2.01 Then the radial distance from the center of the photo to the top of the tower is 56.43 mm. Then flying height is 1220 meters above the base of the tower. Find the height. The height h is equal to dh by r. So d we know that here it is given relief displacement 2.01 mm. Then capital H has given flying height 1220 meters above the base of the tower. Then r radial distance is also given here 56.43 mm. So from the equation h is equal to 43.4 meters. So likewise, when you know the see as in the given varied terrain section or diagram, here we are able to identify there are two points are existing here. Then when you know the details of the different points from the terrain, so we can find out the displacement for the each and every point. Here we are able to identify the height. So here the displacement d can be calculated. If it is single point, d is equal to rh by capital H. When we have the point two points called a and b, da is equal to ra ha by h. Then db is equal to ra rb hb by h. Here HA and HB are nothing but respective heights of A and B. Okay, so here you can see that referring the vertical photograph which is shown here. Assume that radial distances RA to the point A is 63.84, then RB is 62.65. We have different radial displacements, I mean distances from origin to the photo. Then flying height is common, right? H is equal to 1220 meters. Point A is 152 meters above the datum. B is 168 meters below the datum. You try to understand here. So B is below the datum. So that's why we need to understand value is in the form of negative. If it is also above, where we can consider it as positive, right? So find the radial distance. Radial distance and the direction one must see here. So displacement or distance d is equal to radial displacement d is equal to r by h by h. dA is equal to ra. Radial distance of point A is 63.82 and ha is nothing but height above the terrain of point A is 152 meters by capital H is equal to 7.95 mm. Plot inward, that's why it is see that A dash is plotted inside to the point A. So whereas in the case of point DB, RB HB by H. RB is nothing but radial distance. Then HB is nothing but, here we need to understand point B below the datum. That's why we are considering it as minus 168. So then DB is equal to minus 8.63. Okay, thank you for patient listening.